This recording contains adults using adult language. Consider this your fair warning and enjoy.
There's a lot of not in
there. It makes
it
sound like we cannot manually, you know, realign this, obviously. There are holographic controls for it, but apparently they don't have the holographic controls here. What the fuck?
It says holographic controls apparatus. So there's a device that controls the holographic controls. You just don't have that device, that apparatus.
If you tell me that there was something at the very beginning we could have picked up that would have been that thing, I will slap you.
That's what you get, ultimately.
All right. Well, we need oxygen more than anything else.
This is true.
At this point in time, so we should probably pick a way to go.
You're not exactly starving for oxygen. You're not saying, it's just...
No, but you're not exactly lightheaded, but you're like, oh.
No.
This, like, light headache.
You're not even feeling it yet. You just know that the air's gotten thinner. And you're like, oh, okay. Well, it will eventually affect us.
Just let me know when it's at a point where my gun won't fire, because then I know I'm really in trouble.
Yeah.
If your gun won't fire, I'm pretty sure you're going to be dead by then. Yeah.
Demons don't need to breathe.
Every time you fire your gun, you're taking away a little of the oxygen.
Oh, and the burning skeletons aren't a bigger problem that we had to worry about?
Hey, this entire area was
hermetically sealed safe zone.
Room. Yeah, you had no oxygen in this room, right? That's hence the rush of the air. So, how were they burning before? That's a good question.
Magical.
Breaking the laws of physics right there. I mean, not physics, but anyways, chemistry. There we go. Let's go with that. Moving on.
So we got left, center, or right?
Yep. Pretty
I'd
much.
Like to try the center one first, personally. See if it's maybe an air shaft.
Or more likely an elevator shaft, because air shafts don't tend to have doors.
They might.
You'd be surprised.
Case of emergencies.
Some kind of lift. Too many diams. But anyway, moving on.
I'm all for center. If center will open.
Do we see a panel anywhere for the center?
The door opens, just as all the rest have. And inside, you see just a circular chamber. What you do see, the flashing red light next to the... is a green light. Think of it like a data pad, like a PD, like the classic sci-fi handprint pad.
Mm-hmm.
Think of it like that, and it's just pulsing green, just lightly, just, you know, kind of showing you that, yeah, there's activity, but there's nothing going on. I've got power.
Like what? There probably. Like
yep,
not
yep.
exactly by the door.
Yep, exactly. Yep, just off to the side of the door on the inside.
You know what? Okay, does anybody else want to get in here before I try things?
Oh, scoop in.
Hand on the pad.
We assume Vakak is coming with us. If
no, he's gonna stay there, and if you ever need help, he'll
come back. Okay. He's staying in this room. Is like I'm gonna watch over.
Turns out this is the only way out, and there was only one chance to go up.
That's kind of my worry. My other worry is that something's land on our head.
Well, the hologram thing, he had a lovely little pillar, which, you know, hopefully this is that pillar, because there was something above. It'd be the right area? We will find out.
Yeah, I see what you're looking at, yeah. What happens? The suspense is killing me.
I was just waiting for you guys to finish up. Okay. Nothing.
Fuck.
Nothing
you broke it.
Happens. You put your hand on it, it goes red for a quick second, and then goes back to pulsing green.
Well, clearly this thing's racist to tieflings. I'm out of this bitch.
Alright, right it is.
When in doubt,
okay.
Go right. I'll
I'm
sit behind
base,
you two.
By the way, and have my shield ready to defend us.
Gun is currently loaded, ready to fire.
Zo cracks his knuckles.
Did you fuck up with the polygon tool a bit there, Adam?
Yeah.
That was me last night. Like six times.
Fuck it. I'm just doing this the easy way.
Oh.
La-da.
Okay. Two shiny metal tables or beds stand across from one another. In the center of this oval room with metal restraints positioning at the head, foot, and middle of each table. Metal racks along the north and south walls hold assorted sharp-looking implements. A rounded hutch protrudes from the eastern wall.
I'm going to go right for the hutch.
You can go ahead and go right for the hutch. I'm going to prep my gun, just being like, you open that hutch and something pops out, I'm shooting the thing that pops out.
Oh yeah, definitely ready before I open the hutch.
Okay, you try and open up the hutch, and it's locked. You can't seem to get it open. One thing you do notice on this hutch is one of those, you know, those hand panels that you saw
in the hand panel.
Similar, the exact same thing, blinking green, just like the hand panel.
I'll try my hand on it.
Goes red for a bit, and then it goes back to blinking green.
What kind of lock?
It's literally like a hand palm reader.
Yeah, so big deadbolts in it, not something I can probably...
No, I'm talking like fingerprint reader.
You wouldn't be able to necessarily bash the lock, but you could you might be able to force it open with enough strength.
Or I could try a take 10 with disabled device.
Or you could try and do that.
Go for that.
What's your take 10?
I just need to find my disabled device. 19.
19, too. You're sitting there, and I got this. Shut up. And you're kind of playing with wires a bit. You're playing with pick locks. And it's not just a number. You know, it's not just the classic tumble lock, right?
Where I'm like, let's hotwire this bitch.
Like, it's a bit of hot wiring involved, too. Yeah, a bit of opening up thing. And it finally opens. You get it to open.
Hooray.
Inside the hutch are three vials of glowing blue liquid.
Anybody got spellcraft?
And one other object, but we'll discuss that in a second.
Did Vakak?
I don't know. I don't think I've ever actually seen his character sheet. I'm going to guess that he did. I think he did.
I'm pretty sure Rob did, because if he takes UMD, he takes spellcraft.
Yeah. So, you get... three? These potions of blue liquid are potions of cure light wounds.
Nice.
Cool.
One each, I'm thinking.
I'm going to agree with
that. Fair is fair.
Sure.
Okay. So what you also get is this some sort of it's an object, like a you and I, we would understand it as some sort of injection, right? Like something you would, a wand-like device of some sort. Seems to contain a reservoir of liquid at one end and a small pad at the other.
Like an EpiPen?
Yeah. Yeah. Something like an EpiPen.
With a vial?
Yep. Interesting.
Does it seem magical in nature?
All I've got is detect magic. I can't do the spellcraft thing on it.
That's fine. Detect magic's a good start.
No intelligent skills that I could use for, like, if I needed dungeoneering or anything like that, so...
It doesn't seem magical.
Try it a second time.
No, it doesn't seem magical.
You know what? I have a plan. Let's try a disabled device on this bitch for taking 10.
Okay.
Because Mama wants to live another day with 19.
Well, I was just like... Would 19? Disabled device work that way, or are you just disabling this thing from functioning?
If I got the other one to open, I should be able to hotwire this one to
go. Yeah, which means you disabled a lock, as opposed, like, if that's the thing that activates this, wouldn't disabling it stop it from working?
Your logic doesn't work here.
So you see, you start hot wiring this thing, and no, you're not able to get it to do something.
All right, next door.
Next door.
Yep. Sounds good.
Please lead the way, burly gentleman that I would rather not shoot at.
Let there be maybe a dead body whose hand we could take.
Definitely not the skeleton.
Rows of metal shelving fill this room. The shelves bear the look of long disuse, but are surprisingly dust-free. Considering the age of this place, most of the shelves
that's
hold
disturbing.
Assorted. Well, you guys know it was a hermetically sealed area with no air or oxygen. Without that, you can't have dust. Most of the shelves hold assorted pieces of machinery, wires, gears, and cases of bolts and screws. Though nothing seems organized in any logical fashion.
Perceptively.
Take 10 for a perception.
See, okay.
Find take 20 to perceive and loot.
Yeah, can we do a take 20 for this?
Lucia on that. Take 20. Perceive and loot.
Okay. Go ahead and give me some perception numbers.
24.
Okay, with that, you're able to get a few things.
27.
It's a straight up d20 and then whatever. Plus 6, right?
Yeah, in this case, in this case, rather than roll, you're saying I'm going to take a 20 on that die, period.
Got it.
Right, add my 6.
Yeah, so I'm 26 then.
Yeah, it's essentially assuming that you guys are walking back and forth a lot more often than just looking over it once. You're kind of taking a look. You're ruffling through stuff. You're taking things off the shelf. You know, you're ruffling through it all. So first thing you get is a box identical to a box containing an object, a pad, similar to the other two that you've seen. But the box... this object, this pad, is contained in the box, so it's like a part, right? Anyone would understand it. It's like a part you got shipped from FedEx type of thing. And this part, this pad, you have this pad. It's not active. It's inactive. But what you find on the back, painted on the underside of the box lid. So you know, you open up the box, you look at this pad, but right at the underside of that box lid, you see a sequence of numbers. Ready to write this down?
Yep.
I'll let
9, 9, 2, 7, 4, 6.
9, 9, 2, 7, 4, 6.
Minus one of the nines.
Okay.
So
5-digit.
Does any of you speak Goblin?
Don't think
nope.
So.
Definitively not.
Languages, nope.
Okay, there is strange writing on it, but you don't understand it. Sort of short message. In addition, you're able to find a few other things, a few interesting things. Let's go to page 19 so we can find out what that is. We'll tell them what they've won today. There's this device appears hand-sized, flattened metallic sphere.
Okay.
Yeah. So they're like two half orbs.
What is this continuum where it's a time travel device? I shove them together.
Well, they are together.
Ah.
Can we see if it fits in any place anywhere in the main room? See if the device fits in anything.
That is a good idea.
What you do is you bring it back to the CAC as you would normally detect magic. It does show up as magical. You're able to determine that this thing kind of acts in a strange way, similar to rope of climbing. Knotted rope of climbing. So essentially what this thing does is you separate the two spheres, right? The two halves of the spheres. One half levitates about 40 feet above the other, connecting the second half by a beam of violet energy. So there's like these two halves, two semicircles, and between them connects this violet energy.
How high up was the shaft?
Not very high.
Lightsaber bola. You gotta
think like elevator height. You know, not very high ceiling. And you find that in this field, this purple aura, gravity itself seems to be affected. It's as if you could like just climb up this violet, as if it's a rope in and of itself. Like you're just climbing the air between the two devices. So essentially, mechanically, guys, I'll just give it. It's mechanically acting as a knotted rope of climbing. And he closes it because he goes, you only have so much time with it.
Yeah.
It can only be active. It has a battery that can only last for so long. So don't want to keep it active for too long.
So
found, would that fit in any of the hole, like in any holes maybe in the main room? Like in any of the panels?
Does the handprint pad fit anywhere in any of those panels? Or do I see any numerical pad that I could put the code into?
No, you have not seen anything like that.
Fuck.
Would we be able to replace the hand pad?
Probably not, knowing the skill set that you have. Sure, you can do a little bit of hot wiring, but who knows if it has any code embedded in it, right? You could be... Probably not. I'm going to guess none of you took the...
Technomancy?
Thank you, Technomancy.
Nope, definitely.
Fortunately, no.
Definitely not.
I got 1 feat, and I wanted to be able to reload as a move action rather than standard.
This other item that you got through searching, right? You got 3 items in total. Is a subsonic vermin manipulator. It's a handheld disc with indentations that hum softly when pressed. You do it. Doesn't really seem to do much for you, but what you do know is it acts as a pipes of the sewers. Basically, what it does, it's like a little keyboard, right? You can think of it like a little keyboard or ocarina, right?
Mm-hmm.
Similar to an ocarina, but it's instead a keyboard, right? Instead of having to blow air into it, it's just a bunch of keys, little hand keyboard. Okay. And what it does is it attracts all of the, you know, rats and small vermin. It tends to attract small vermin. But you've turned it on, and there doesn't seem to be vermin in here, as you would expect, since there was no oxygen.
Hermetically sealed. All right. But
that's what you know it does.
So, would it be possible to use that knotted rope climbing device to go up in the shaft, since we can't use the apparent elevator?
Absolutely. You give it a shot, but you realize that the roof is a solid steel, just as everything else. It doesn't go... The shaft isn't a shaft going all the way up.
We're in a like, room in the shaft.
Like an elevator.
Yeah, you're in a room, similar to an elevator, yeah.
Can I find anything in the ceiling with a take 20 of perception?
One thing
like you guys, how there's an escape hatch.
One thing you guys... No, there's no escape hatch. It's sealed, like even to the edges of the wall, the shaft and the room.
It's seamless.
It's perfect. Like this thing wouldn't even let air through.
Throwing acid on something like this, would that make a difference?
The amount of acid you can do, the amount of damage you do, because they have hardness, probably not. You probably wouldn't do much, considering how thick this stuff is. I'll just tell you that rather than wasting your time and letting you do a bunch of rolls. One thing I can tell you guys haven't done, because Jesus Christ, it's been a long time. What's the one thing you do in every adventure whenever you kill enemies in a room?
Oh, loot the room.
Never forget to loot the room.
Well, how are we to expect these guys to have something that, like, a biometric scanner would be able to activate?
One of the skeleton bodies turned to dust. I didn't figure there'd be much left.
I kind of described them bashing you with gauntlets.
Good point. Can we pick one of those gauntlets up?
And try it on the pad in the elevator?
The gauntlets are the only thing that seems to have survived.
Can I take the gauntlets and use them?
If you want.
They
don't really add much damage to you.
Did the lightning and that not come from the gauntlets?
No, it came from the creatures themselves.
Oh, fuck that then.
How about you take one? And put it on the pad.
So okay. You put a gauntlet on your hand, and You put it up against the pad, and the green, it lights up green and then turns into a number pad.
Pass it over here. I want to try it on this pad thing that I'm holding.
Okay.
What?
He wants to use it on the hand, pad that isn't connected to anything.
Yeah, the handprint pad.
Oh, it doesn't do anything. It's not lit up.
Damn.
No activity.
All right, let's put that 9.
Put in the numbers that you said you wrote down.
92746 is indeed what it is. Good job, Cowboy. See,
I wrote it down.
So the elevator doors close. The pad turns yellow, and you feel this jerking motion, right? You're going upwards.
Oh, thank Lord. We're leaving three people behind.
Hang on. Doop. Fucking elevator. Does that have to be a WAV file, or does it matter? Thank you for noticing what I wanted you to do, Cowboy.
Yeah, not a problem. I figured you wanted me there so you wouldn't fold over if someone came through that door.
Like, I have nice AC, but...
It's too bad viewers won't be able to hear the music.
I'm prepped to make sure that we don't die.
For those of you listening, just picture the most, like, cliched, stereotypical elevator music you've ever heard, and that's what we can hear.
So, Avril Lavigne's Skater Boy without lyrics and slowed to the point where it's almost not recognizable. Okay.
Sure,
that's what elevator music ever really is. It's just pop culture hits slowed and lyric removed. Still going?
Apparently.
He's probably prepping things while this is going. It's like his timer.
I'm not sure how long it is. Is a good thing. It's either a good thing we're going to pop out on the surface, or it's a really bad thing and we're going to be dead. There will be no in between.
No, we pop up on the Vogan homeworld because it's actually a space set. Space shaft, and every step we take, we get smacked with a hand that pops out of the ground.
Such a good movie.
Are we there
gotta
yet?
Watch that. I haven't seen it in a while.
Do I see the speaker that's playing this music? And if so, does it look shootable?
Or bashable?
I think he's using this music to take a break as we ride up this elevator that is taking an ungodly amount of time.
He made it play on a 20-minute loop just so he could go drop a deuce.
You're probably right.
I would or maybe not he's put making it past dinner him.
And eating. Oh, Stuart, guess what I did this weekend, by the way?
What's that?
Finally have my gun license.
Nice, good job.
Thank
did
you.
So,
did you go for restricted, non-restricted, or?
Actually, I did my non-restricted and hunting this weekend, and then the 20th is my restricted.
Nice.
Yeah, so I still need to get my hunting. Everything in.
Then again, since I don't really have plans.
With
to...
a lurch!
Oh.
Yeah. It jolts to a halt.
Does flashing... the door open?
No. A flashing red light appears next to the door opening panel, accompanied by a faint buzzing sound.
Okay.
And what you get is sort of, you can imagine, a GLaDOS voice. Negligible atmosphere detected. Do you wish to proceed? Push open button twice for yes.
No. Negligible is a bad word.
So essentially what I'm getting from this is if we open up this door, the entirety of air that's going to be in this room is what's in the elevator right now, which is practically negligible to begin with.
So
then
here's
again,
the,
negligible here's... and negligible cancels out into a positive. So this could be good, guys.
This isn't math where there's double negatives that work out well. This is life. So here's the real question. Double Can any of you out. Hold your breath long enough for this elevator to go back down?
Depends. How do we calculate holding your breath again? Because I know that's like an underwater mechanic, something to do with constitution.
It is.
I don't remember what it is. Is it twice your con score? Is the number of rounds you can hold it for, or something like that? Do I look this up as nobody says anything?
I'm getting all the details.
I'm looking it up right now.
Can I do a detect undead actually while we're standing here thinking about whether we're gonna possibly
through solid metal doors?
Die? Sure. Okay, here first I'll give you the suffocation. A character who has no air to breathe can hold her breath for 2 rounds per point of constitution.
Okay, so double your con score.
Yep. If a character takes a standard or a full round action, the remaining duration that character can hold their breath is reduced by 1 round. So every time you take a standard, you reduce that maximum by 1.
Oh, Christ.
Wow. After this period of time, the character must make a DC 10 constitution check in order to continue holding your breath. The check must be repeated each round, with the DC increasing by 1 for every previous success. When the character fails on one of these constitution checks, she begins to suffocate. In the first round, she falls unconscious. In the following round, she drops to -1 hit points. In the third round, she suffocates.
How many rounds did it take for us to come up here?
If you not very
pick a number?
If I were to pick a number, we'll go with about 12 seconds, so 2 rounds.
Oh, that's not bad. So I could hold my breath for a total of 28 rounds.
20 here.
28 here.
Which I would call like a minute. 2 minutes.
Yeah, that would be 2 minutes.
Natural so. Lung capacity. Because assuming we're all competent in, you know, knowing how to not breathe for a little bit, we could essentially
repeatedly send the elevator up and down, hopefully giving up enough air so that we don't die in 2 minutes.
No, not what I'm thinking. Scouting is very important to knowing your enemy and where you are. Well, as long as we can hold our breath long enough, open the door, see what's there, close the door, and go back down to where there is air.
Can we do the detect undead first?
Yes.
Sure.
Just to see if there's something dead on the other side first?
Detect undead, I think, can't go through certain solid objects, can't go through certain thickness of objects.
Oh, yeah, okay. I think it's like anything more than like a meter wall kind of thing, it wouldn't be able to go through.
Well, far less than a meter.
Well, just saying.
Detect magic. Hey, yeah. Magic.
Penetrates barriers but 1 foot of stone, 1 inch of common metal, thin sheet of lead, or 3 feet of wood or dirt blocks.
There you go. So, no, you don't detect any.
So we probably have to open the door. Everybody take a deep breath.
All right, let's do it.
All right.
Hang on. Put the glove on and get ready to tap.
Okay, yeah.
We need to do this fast. And hold breath, prep gun. In an area where I'm not going to have. Fuck!
Where are we? Oh, over there.